Hi guys! So today I have a story time for you guys about the time when I had a huge crush on this boy and I stalked him for 5 years. Basically, the story starts when I was in first grade and my best friend and I, Alyssa, let's call her, we were like sisters and we loved everything the same. So we had, you know, the same taste in boys, the same taste in almost everything. So this one day we were walking in the hallway somewhere in school, I don't remember exactly where, and we were walking and this super adorable and cute guy was walking in front of us, and he was a little bit tan but still really really pale but kind of tan, and he had like blonde brown hair, blue eyes, and oh my god, so cute. And we fell in love with him as soon as we saw him. It was love at first sight, guys. And I remember thinking,
oh my god, I love this guy, I need him, he would be my boyfriend
and stuff like that. And I was like 7 years old back then. Alyssa liked him too, and we both would talk about him all day long. We were like daydreaming about him all the time, and we decided to stalk him everywhere he went. So when he went to, you know, football or to different classes, we would be in the background. You could probably see pictures of us in the background if he released those somewhere. We were in the background, because when he was walking, we were like this. Like that, in the background. And we were obsessed with him. We would talk about him all the time. And this one time, I think in third grade, something really embarrassing happened. Because my friend and I, Alyssa, we were sitting at the bench. We were watching him playing football. And he was so hot playing football. We were in third grade, by the way, and he was in fourth grade. He was 1 year older than us. And he was so cute, and we were like,
oh my god, cute.
And so he was playing, and I told Alyssa,
oh my god, Alyssa, he looks like a tomato, he's so red.
And I don't know which one of us decided to do this, but we decided to scream out,
you look like a tomato, Alex.
But he didn't hear it, I don't think, because he didn't look at us, and we said his name, Alex. You know, so we did that. Our teacher was right behind us and we didn't know, and she came to us and she said,
Maria, Alyssa, that is not a very nice thing to say, kids. You should not say that to other boys or girls.
And we didn't want to offend him, but when you have a crush, you kind of want to harass them a little bit and be like, oh. So basically that was our life from grade 1 to grade 4, that is all we did. Now when we came to grade 4, we slowly realized that Alex wouldn't be in our lives anymore, because once he graduated from grade 5, he would move on to a bigger school for grade 6 to 9. So we wouldn't have him for the whole grade 5. And we were a kind of like having a midlife crisis right there. And we were like,
oh my god, Alex won't be with us anymore. How will we survive? How will we eat? How will we sleep? How will we do anything?
And we were like creepers, guys. And we had such huge problem with this, because the school was like 30 minutes away from us. So we had to walk all the way there. And we didn't want to walk because we were so lazy. We were basically, you know, breaking up with him for a year. And we were devastated. So when we came back to fifth grade, he wasn't there anymore. And we had nobody to stalk and kind of went insane. But I was a bit more stalker-like, I think. Because I saw him one time when I was like going outside somewhere. And I saw Alex and I was thinking,
oh my god, Alyssa isn't here. This is my time to shine. I can go to him. I can walk behind him by myself and just look at him.
So I don't know why I did it, but I walked behind him, a few meters behind him, while he walked in front of me to his school. While he was walking, I was just imagining, you know, what would happen if I went up to him and was like,
hello, Alex. I have been having a crush on you for like 4 years now. Do you want to be my boyfriend?
That was only in my head. I did not do it, guys. I just stayed a coward and I was in the background just watching him. Finally, fifth grade ended, thank God. And after fifth grade, we were going to his school because we were going to sixth grade, he was going to seventh grade. So we would be in the same school again and we were freaking out because we were like,
we can have him.
So we went there and to our disappointment, he was standing there looking as cute as ever. And he was like, and when he opened his mouth, I saw he had braces. He had this huge blue braces. And back then I was so stupid, you know, because I thought like, if you have braces, you can't kiss the guy because you would get cut. You know, because if you kiss him, you would get cut on your lips, and I did not want to get cut. I was so stupid, guys. Naive and stupid. So it's like, oh my God, we can't even kiss him if we get him. So I kind of didn't want him anymore, because how would I kiss him? So I told Alyssa,
he has braces, how will we kiss him?
And she didn't really think about it that much. She's a lot smarter than me, guys. So she was like,
oh, that's okay. It's okay if he has braces. I don't care. He's still cute.
And then I kind of thought, okay, maybe it's okay. I don't know. But then this girl went up to him and she was all over him, hugging him. And she was like, I hated that girl. She was tall, she was thin, she was blonde and beautiful, and I was like,
I'm going to kill you one day.
But Alex was so into her because of course she looked like a model, and you know, I was so annoyed because he had gotten a girlfriend over the summer and braces. There was too many changes and I kind of was like,
he's not the same guy anymore and I don't know if I want him.
So, you know, during that sixth grade, my love for him kind of went down a bit, but not that much, because on one day he was going up the stairs, I was going down the stairs in our school hallway, and Alyssa and I made like kind of like a bet, but there was no prize, and we were like,
let's go as close to him as we possibly can and let's touch his elbow.
My God, we're so insane. So we went down the stairs, he went up the stairs, and I kind of went like that on his like arm, and I touched his arm. And we were both wearing sweaters, so technically I didn't touch him. But when we were going down and I touched him, in my mind I was screaming. I was like,
oh my God, our first touch. I touched him, he knows about me, I know about his smell.
And no, I did not, and he did not know about me. He didn't even notice. He was just talking to his friends. So it was so disappointing. So my love for him went away a little bit during that point. And Alyssa didn't really care though, because she was still in love with him and she wanted to like follow him wherever he went. So when I was going home from school, I would see her some days and she was like, and I mean, I wanted to do that too, kind of, but because he was wearing braces and I had a girlfriend, my love for him kind of turned down. So I didn't really love him that much anymore, but I was like,
Alyssa, you can have him. I don't want him.
Slowly, my love for him went away, but Alyssa still loved him. So, you know, we were talking about what would happen when we grew older and we could finally, you know, have a boyfriend and stuff, and we were thinking like, which one of us would have him? We can both like share him or anything. I kind of told her that she could have him, but you know, we were thinking before that point, like a few years before, we were thinking like,
oh, we could maybe like share him, you can have him during, you know, one of the weekends and I would have him to the next weekend, so we can have him like every other weekend.
Kind of like, you know, what parents do when they are divorced and they kind of switch the kids around like every other weekend and stuff. My God, we can't do that. We're so naive and we didn't really think, you know, you can't really share a boyfriend like that. But anyways, during that sixth grade, after like 6 months, we moved to the Philippines, my mom and I. So I didn't get him. Alyssa didn't get him. We were just stalking him for like 5 years and none of us got him. We never even got to say hello to him. We didn't even get to nothing, not even eye contact, nothing. We got no love back from him, which was disappointing, but we enjoy just, you know, being like fangirls behind him and just watching him. This is the story of how I stalked our crush for like 5 years. But yeah, I got the story from my diary that I got, you know, I was writing this one back in 2006 a lot. And you know, when I was younger and I still had time, I would write in this one. So I have lots of more other diaries where I have so many stories which I can tell you guys. So tell me down below if you want more stories and I will make sure to do those. So thanks so much guys for watching. Hope this made you laugh and entertained you, and I will see you next time. Bye.
I was going to yawn. I filmed the yawn. That was epic, right?
Good morning guys, it's September 10th, it's 8 a.m. something. I'm 22.
I'm old.
It's the key.